you very much, Carson Daly. We are here in Stockholm, Sweden, what? With the Backstreet Boys. How are you guys doing?
Hello.
Welcome to Sverige. Uh-huh.
Yes. What they say? Welcome to Sweden.
Right. The Swedish meatballs are good.
Now, Sweden's been good to you guys. You guys kind of started off here, right?
This is the first. Stockholm was the first place in Europe that we all traveled together when back in '94 when we were recording our first album.
And Max Martin, Dennis Pop, they're all from here. Totally. We've done memorable work with them.
Lots of good friends here. Lots of good memories here. We know the club scenes and the restaurants pretty good here.
Good. All right, good. I'm going to be getting some advice from you after this interview is over there. So now it's kind of coming full circle because you're up for a couple EMAs. You're huge now all throughout the world. You're up for Best Group and Best Pop. I think you're going to win. Any predictions?
I don't know. We've kind of been out of the scene for a minute, so I don't know if... there's been a lot of new music come out since our last album came out, so we'll see. We'll see what happens.
You're performing, which we're going to see, actually live. Whenever you guys go on, we're going to, as long as it takes, we're staying on the air as long as it takes to catch you guys doing Shape My Heart live, which would be very cool.
Really?
Thank you, Carson. Thank you, everybody back there, home.
Black and Blue is a growth for us. It's another step up from the last albums. I think I'm very happy with it. Me and AJ, we can't stop listening to it. You know, I guess every time we get new music, anyways, we like listen to it. But it's a little bit of a little bit more of our own influence on the album. You know, with the collaborations with like Babyface and Rodney Jerkins did a song called Shining Star, mm-hmm. which cool. we'll talk about in a little bit probably.
Yeah.
and also we did some stuff with the whole Sharon crew over here, and we wrote about seven songs on the album.
Excellent.
All together, we've written about seven songs, and the album's just—it's a little bit of a growth, and it's the same old Backstreet stuff, you know. It's not. I think the main goal, the main thing we wanted to do was not change too far from our original stuff, because sometimes in the past you see like groups and artists, they'll totally change their style and they'll shock the world and they'll be like, that's not them. Right. So we got our old sound in there too, but it's a little bit of a growth.
It's a versatile album as well. A lot of the tracks from track to track is, you notice a difference. We have a little bit of an R&B flavor in some of the tracks. We have a little bit of a country vibe
really?
In some of the tracks. And then we have the straight up pop up tempos Latin. As well. A little bit of Latin flavor. Latin.
Everything.
Right. Okay, and you're going to break the hell out of the sales record, right? In the first week?
I don't know. We'll see.
We're just happy to make good music.
We pray. We hope.
That happens.
God pray to God. Everybody go out and buy a nice record.
Well, you're going to sell a ton, no matter what.
Yeah.
Well,
we hope to.
We'd like to think so.
Right. We don't want to count anywhere near chickens before they hatch, as my mom would say.
But, it's just good music, hopefully, that our fans will enjoy. That's all that we want.
Excellent. We're going to be talking about some of the tracks, and we're going to be catching you guys doing Shape My Heart live from the EMAs, so stay tuned for that. We've got more of the Backstreet Boys coming up. Back to you, Carson. We're talking about some of the tracks from Black and Blue, kind of previewing them, if you will. Let's talk Shining Star. This is one you did with Rodney Jerkins.
Yes.
Yep.
It's actually a song that we got from some people from Sweden, and by the name of Francis and
LePont.
And actually, Kevin found this song, plus another song called More Than That, and brought it to us, and we all really liked it. And we decided to have Ronnie produce it. And once we got the final production of the thing, Nikki and myself actually did a little bit of rewriting with him and came up with a little B chorus in the very end. So now we were able to add our names upon that as one of the seven songs that we actually tried.
I think it's one of the songs that are in competition for the next single. Contention, my bad, competition, whatever.
Now, what goes into a decision like that? Is it just personal feelings? How do you decide on a song?
Just, it's if we feel like radio will respond to it, how we feel about it personally.
Record company, together talking with the management.
The bad thing is that we have to shoot the video in about 2 weeks, so... We need to make a decision.
Real soon.
It's like my favorite song.
We've been very, very fortunate. No, sorry. I mean, interrupt. We've been very, very fortunate in our past two albums that we've gone four or five singles deep, and you can't always depend on that. So you have to, take advantage and make sure that it's almost like playing a deck of cards, and you have to have the right play for the whole realm of everything, for the fans, the radio, everybody. So.
Support.
Ryan.
We're going to be talking about more of these tracks that are going to become a part of your lives very soon when Black and Blue is released on the 21st. Got more of that coming up. Back to you, Carson.
The last movie that I went and saw was Almost Famous. Kate Hudson did a great job. She's got a new fan on me. She did an incredible job. And there's a lot in that movie that I can relate to because of the music business. So.
Oh no, no.
Let's sing again.
Time, look where we are and what we've been through. Time, sharing our dreams.
Every little bit of life with you.
Time, it goes on and on every day. Oh, time is what it is.
Nice! Little instant a cappella of Time from the upcoming album Black and Blue. Let's talk about that track. You co-wrote that, right?
We wrote that. All five of us together wrote that, and we recruited Babyface to produce it for the album.
That's a score.
And he's actually, it's on the chorus, it's six-part harmony, and he's actually singing a harmony in the middle, so we actually have a performance on the track with Babyface, so it's cool.
Favorite CD of all time would be... I would have to say James Taylor's Greatest Hits. I admire him as an artist and as a singer and a songwriter, and I think he has definitely stood the test of time.
The last video game that I recently bought was Resident Evil 2. I'm usually a little bit late on video games and stuff like that, but I like to go back and play old video games and sometimes new video games, but Resident Evil 2, and I still haven't beat it yet because I haven't had time yet. I'm going to do it very soon.
Okay.
If I had to pick somebody in Hollywood to play the life story of Howie D, I'd pick Lou Diamond Phillips. Yes, I think he did a great job in the portrayal of La Bamba. And since our life has kind of got that little Latin kind of musical feel, I think he'd do a good job.
Okay, Emily, now the last concert that I attended as a fan was... Jackson 5 reunion tour when I was about 7 years old at Joe Robbie Stadium in Miami. It was the last time I actually went to a concert and saw, without the fellas, I mean, but that was when I was really, truly a fan.
I'm not kidding. I know
Jackson
5.
It was the loudest concert I've ever been to. Explosions and crazy things, but it was still the Jackson 5, which was a once-in-a-lifetime thing for me to see.
The movie that I recently saw was, here's a clue, Stan Lee. X-Men. Well, I really like the movie X-Men because of the fact that I am a big fan of comics, and we happen to be working with Stan Lee, and he was one of the creators of the X-Men back in the day. So that's the reason that I like the X-Men. I thought it was a great movie.
The last movie I went and saw was... And the answer is Pay It Forward.
There was one song I wish I never had to hear again. It would probably be... Bye, bye, bye.
New favorite piece of clothing would be... Boom! I would have to say, I'm not wearing it right now, but my skull cap that I had on in the Shape of My Heart video shoot. I've been wearing it every single day since then. I love that hat. It's been keeping my head warm while we've been on tour, and, you know, the rest of the guys are ragging on me about it, too, so... And no, it doesn't smell, Tim, but either way, it's a great freaking hat.
If I, or the Backstreet Boys, had a chance to sing a duet with anybody, dead or alive, it'd probably be Michael Jackson. I think we're all big fans of his. We've all grown up listening to his music. And we actually almost had the opportunity to do it on this album here. But unfortunately, because of time schedules and record company politics, we weren't able to do it. But maybe the next album or in the future.
We're sorry we couldn't be there with y'all during the Spankin' New Music Week.
Yeah, but we hear that you're gonna be handing out some CDs of ours, some of the Black and Blue CDs, out to everybody out there in Times Square at the end of the show.
Thank you for that, but we'll see you in person on November 21st when we're launching our new album with you in Times Square. Peace.
Back at MTV.
I mean, when we travel like we do, it's good to eat healthy. A lot of times we start out, like first couple of days, eating really healthy, and then by the third or fourth day, it's usually whatever you can grab and put in your mouth. Don't take that anywhere. Right?
And what, I mean, people eat carrots to make their hair curly. What do you eat to make your hair go blue?
I eat fast food.
Figs.
Figs, yes, oh, yeah, brown really. Figs. No.
No, that's a tip and a half.
Yeah, right.
Figs to make your hair
eat figs
blue.
And your hair grows 7 inches longer and it turns blue.
And I'm going to ask you how many figs you had to eat to get it that blue. It looks good.
A lot of figs.
You going to keep it for long?
Just until Tuesday, and then I'm getting rid of the fake added stuff.
Okay, so this whole thing, why we're here, is because you're in Stockholm. This is Stockholm Music Week. It's the MTV Europe Music Awards. You're promoting an album, which is going to come out soon, but you're doing it in a very ambitious way, which we're going to talk about in a bit more detail. It's a very, very busy week, and I believe you're familiar with Stockholm. You're here in the summer recording. Do you want to tell me a bit about that?
Yeah, we're just here finishing up some last tracks for our album Black and Blue, which is coming out November 20th here, and in the States, November 21st. And we recorded about 7 songs here with the whole Swedish Sharon team, Max, Martin, Rami, Christian, Andreas. And we're starting off our 6 continents promotional tour for the release of the album here in Sweden, and starting off actually tomorrow, and then leaving to Tokyo, Japan, then Sydney, Australia, then Cape Town, South Africa, and Rio, South America, and then ending it off back in our homeland of New York City.
How are you sound so cool saying that? I mean, aren't you kind of like, wow, we're going around the world? Isn't it kind of, wow? And you're the first band, you're the first group to do it, yeah?
Yeah.
I think so, yeah.
And they just sit here nodding, really kind of, yeah, well, really, you know, somebody has to do it.
We haven't really psyched ourselves up. I think tomorrow we get on that 9-hour flight
excited,
to
We've
Tokyo.
We've been planning it. We've been planning it for 3-4 months now, yeah. So.
With us, the
getting older, and
we want our music to be for
all demographics, all people. You know, our audience is growing with us. Mm-hmm. We have a large adult contemporary audience. Our first number one single was on the adult contemporary radio here in the U.S. So,
Actually, you should be. When she's 30, we're all still gonna be in our 20s.
I mean, you know, we're still gonna have some really funky stuff. Funky young stuff.
You should be Backstreet Boys and Men.
Yeah,
Boys and Men.
Boys and Men.
Mm. Ever thought about that?
Backstreet Boys and Men.
And Men.
Me and you are still boys.
Oh, so I'm not a man,
oh,
Howie?
Man.
Hey,
oh, you just said it.
I'm not a man, Howie.
Still young. Young.
What do you like about Sweden, or maybe Stockholm, should I say?
It kind of feels like home to me. You know?
It was the first place we ever went to in Europe. So, you know, it was like, it's like our second home. I mean, we know the places to go. We know where all the clubs are. We know where all the fast food places are, restaurants are.
It's one of the places that I, like, maybe someday if I ever wanted to get a house somewhere else, that's where I probably might get it.
Is Stockholm or?
Stockholm, maybe outskirts of Stockholm, probably. Just a little outskirts. More in a country land.
And the people there are unbelievable.
Unbelievable.
you guys speak Swedish now?
Nope.
They'll call me to say it, yeah. I know a couple of dirty words, but...
Yeah, say them.
No, they're bad. And I don't want to disrespect you. They're really bad.
Yeah, that's what the...
Oh, I do too.
Our friends.
Okay.
Yeah, that's what Max and them teach us.